Hey guys, down in the basement. Yeah, finally wrapping up the GE800. It's been a long time coming between the rodent infestation and the furnace dying and getting COVID and just all sorts of fun distractions. I finally want to wrap this up, then I'm decommissioning this workbench. So, I'll recap a little bit. This was an extremely frustrating set to work on. Partly because it had been worked on before, stuff had been tinkered with, and it's just a difficult chassis to work on. Eventually I figured out that the flyback had been replaced. The replacement flyback I just could not make work right, so I dug up yet another replacement flyback, installed it, tinkered around, and got it to work acceptably. I was also playing around with the damper circuit. I now have a 25AX4 in there in place of the original 25W4. And hiding back in there, it's a bit of an upgrade. It has a little bit higher specs on it. I put in a new old stock 19 BG6, and I am happy with the performance. I also had to come to terms with this is just a finicky set. It's touchy. It's an odd design. It's an early design. I think it's a first series strung TV. But for like a 1948 TV, that's really good. So one of the performance quirks is the contrast control has a profound impact on everything. So I'm touching it now, because when you turn down the contrast, it's cutting the gain, which reduces the amplitude of the sync pulses. So as when you reduce the contrast, you start losing sync. Also, we had some dirty controls up front, or some bad controls that were really, really headache-inducing. One of my more frustrating sets to work on, that's for sure. But I'm happy with the way it's working now. So, I'm going to let this play, and while I leave it play for a few hours off and on, I'm going to finish cleaning up the cabinet, and let's put this puppy all back together and finish this off finally. Why is that glowing so long, you may wonder? Well, the power's been drained from the rest of the set, but the electron beam, this is a really good CRT, that there's still electrons being emitted as the gun is cooling off, and the high voltage filter cap is holding enough of charge that it's pulling it towards the front. The outer conductive coating on the CRT combined with the inner conductive coating on the CRT forms a capacitor, so that's holding a high voltage charge to attract the electrons forward, and this CRT is so fresh that even when power is turned off, as long as that filament is hot, it's still emitting electrons, and they're hitting the front and making that bright spot. I'm doing a final inspection underneath the chassis before I slide it into the cabinet. Also, I just went through and cleaned up the tuner. A whole bunch of wafer switches. I cleaned it up with deoxit. Now, rather than just spraying deoxit all over inside the chassis, I put it under the tip of a Q-tip and then ran it around where the actual metal contacts are. And I flushed out the old grease and the switch ratcheting mechanism and put some new grease in there. So it's working rather nicely now. And I cleaned up the volume control up here, which seemed a little scratchy. And I think that'll be it. Somebody already added a fuse holder, so got that out of the way. Everything, all the screws I've had taken out have been replaced. Everything is secured. So I think we are good to go to start putting this back together. In case anyone was wondering what type of grease do I use when lubricating such rotary switch mechanisms as this, as well as ball bearing assemblies and radio tuning mechanisms, I use Luber Plate number 105 motor assembly grease. Why? Because I was looking at some Dumont original equipment manufacturer service literature from the late 40s, and they specifically mentioned and recommended using that lubricant, and they still make it, so I figured it was good enough for them back then. That's what I'm going to use. I just slid the chassis back into the cabinet, and now I'm putting the feet back on. And one of the tricks to doing this is, if you got the room, slide it off the edge of your workbench, take 2 feet, flip it around, do the other two. And when I'm making these videos, I have to decide what do I want to show. I mean, I spent hours and hours working on these sets. I'm not going to show you everything. Plus, it will take me forever to finish anything if I'm recording everything. But I try to show you stuff that I haven't seen somebody show before. So one is this trick I use, because these sets are very heavy and I can't tip it on its side, of the chassis will slide over to the side and the holes won't line up. So what I do is, if I can, in this case it's fairly easy to do, is I hang the cabinet and the chassis off the edge and kind of slide things around while looking up through the holes until things seem to line up. And then I put the feet on, and the feet on this set are a little different. And the originals are in decent shape. They're felt pads with metal behind them, and then there's a threaded screw that you can get at through the center of the felt. And they screw up, and they not only provide feet, but they hold the chassis in place. And by the way, if I haven't mentioned it yet, I'll mention it again. I am recovering from COVID. I don't want to get into the politics or anything. I'll just tell you, it's been an unpleasant experience, and I have a very strange side effect that's emerged over the last 2 days, which is that any food or sauce that has vinegar in it tastes horrible and smells horrible. I've heard a lot of people losing their sense of smell. I wish. No, mine has changed. So, ketchup, mustard, salad dressing, pickles, they're all absolutely horrible to me. I cannot eat them. I hope that goes away eventually. Also, I am weak. I can only work for maybe half an hour to an hour before I gotta lie down for a while. I hope that also passes quickly, because I got lots of projects to get to. Now I'm doing the front side, and this side is kind of unique, and the front is a separate piece, so I can clean the pitcher tube off and all that while still mounting it in the cabinet. So here's what I'm doing. There's the chassis, the cabinet. I look down through that and slide the chassis around till the holes line up and mount the feet on. Simple as that. I've got the front attached now, and I'm doing final cleaning on the aluminum recessed painted panel now, and I'm using my new favorite universal cleaner Gojo to kind of clean off any little bits of crud. It's not harming the paint, it's not harming the metal. Does a good job dissolving all the built up gunk from people manipulating the controls over the years, which just will leave the knobs. Kind of cool that the original felts are on here too, so these would go behind the knobs. That's one reason the control panel is in such good shape, is because it was protected by the felt all these years. So we just let this sit a little while and then wipe it off, and that should be all the cleaning that's necessary. I'll clean the knobs with a toothbrush. A toothbrush and some warm soapy water, and then cross my fingers and toes and turn this set on and hope everything is still working properly so I can get this set back to its owner finally. Here's the set all back together finally and playing fairly well. I'll give GE credit and some admiration for creating a unique design, but both the very striking Bakelite cabinet, and the internal circuit design. I don't know if they had engineering rivalries with RCA or pride in their engineering department, but it seems that rather than licensing or cloning anything that RCA had done, they went their own way. And I think in some cases, particularly with the horizontal sync circuitry, didn't quite work so well. They were pioneering it. It's the first series strung set, magnetically deflected series strung set, I do believe. The first to use a 19BG6 and 25W4 damper tube. It has DC restoration, which generally makes the picture better as scenes change from light to dark. All that being said, once you get everything adjusted properly, it's a very watchable picture. Nice clear sound. The wifey is mine. But it was a little finicky, especially with the contrast control, which I'm adjusting right now. So you get a little bit too far one way or the other way. What about his mother? Does it has a dramatic effect on the picture.
A couple, I guess. I tried calling some today, but
that's the brightness. But it's working. It's working, and it's all back together. So I've contacted the owner. He is going to come pick it up as soon as we're cleared of our COVID quarantine. And he has more sets for me to restore, two Predictas. And he was just contacted by another local gentleman who's got a Predicta, and another one a little bit further away who's got a Predicta. And I have a few of my own. So basically, I'm lining up about 8 of the 17-inch variety. And once I got a new workbench set up, I'm going to set up like a little assembly line, and we're going to go through and we're going to do a whole bunch of predictors. Meanwhile, I hope you enjoyed this long, drawn-out restoration series on a classic GE800, aka the locomotive, black and white TV from around 1948.